Hi, dear student. Welcome to my channel. So in this slot, we're going to discuss the forecast question for SPM 2020. I will focus on paper 1 and paper 2. Alright, so paper 1, okay, and paper 2. And those having this module, please stay focused in this slot. So because I got change, do a lot of changes on this module. And for those don't have this module, please subscribe. For the students don't have this module, please subscribe my channel on YouTube. YouTube channel Boundless Chemistry, and you can text to my phone number. I will send the module for you guys. Alright, so move on to the paper 2, section A. So this year SPM 2020, the forecast question will be heat of neutron, heat of heating and cooling process of naphthalene, empirical formula of magnesium oxide, predict table. Again, drawing will be carbon dioxide or sodium oxide, and the second question, structure question, will be under electrolysis and electroplating, thermal decomposition of metal nitrate, which is zinc nitrate or lead 2 nitrate, confirmatory test for zinc nitrate and nitrate ion and ion, titration process, the pH value of acid, and the role of water in showing acidicity, U-tube cell, alright, carbon compound, the conversion of carbon compound, combustion, fermentation, dehydration, hydration, oxidation, okay, Arbor process and contact process. Alright, so we go for section B essay question, which carry 20 marks. Alright, so stay focused on glass, polymer, modern medicine, food additive, redox reaction, which of the following non-redox reaction, calculation on the oxidation number, displacement reaction, and the second question, chemical bonding, the formation of ionic and covalent bonding, salt, okay, preparation of soluble salt that contain, not contain K and an ion. Alright, so, and one more question will be under electrolysis factor. Factor 1 versus factor 2, plus with displacement reaction, and also potential difference between different pair of metals. Alright, so section C, experiment, so rate of reaction, temperature or catalyst factor, and the acid base, preparation of standard solution, and I will do the last slot for the forecast question. So stay focused on my YouTube channel. So in the last slot, I will do forecast question for 10 experiment. Alright, for 10 experiment, I will focus on 10 experiment in the last slot. Alright, we move on to the important definition that students must remember. I'll start with first one, isotope. Okay, what is mean by isotope? Isotope means atoms of same element which have same proton number but different nuclear number, or student can take a number of protons and number of neutrons. Alright, number of neutrons, and the second definition will be relative atomic mass, RAM, okay, carbon 12. Alright, check the answer given here. Why the carbon 12 is used as a standard atom in determining the relative atomic mass? Because exists in, okay, in solid state, very easy to handle, most abundant element, all that must remember. Alright, so we go for what is the definition for one mole. Must remember for objective question, one mole means the quantity of substance that contain as many particle as exactly in 12 gram of carbon 12. Must remember 12 gram carbon 12. All right so the very important definition that student must remember is empirical formula. So what is mean by empirical formula? Empirical formula, the formula that shows simplest ratio of all number of atoms of each elements that present in a compound. All right so we go for next definition. What is period? Period is horizontal, group is vertical. So what is mean by period? Horizontal row of elements in the periodic table, vertical column of element in the periodic table will be under group. Alright, so we move on to the next one, strong acid. Please remember, okay, all these alloy, rate of reaction, redox reaction, displacement, heat of neutralization, heat of combustion, please study before your exam. Alright, so we move on to the next one, important equation. The equation carries 2 marks, must write the correct formula and also balance the equation. We check the number 1. Alright, so magnesium react with oxygen, we will get magnesium oxide. Must balance the equation. If can try to put the symbol of heated here. Alright, so we try to do another one, zinc react with oxygen. We will get zinc oxide, balance the equation, balance oxygen. Oxygen put 2 here, zinc put 2 here. And remember, zinc oxide, the zinc oxide when hot is yellow color. Alright, when cold, it will turn to white color. All these students must remember. Okay, check the copper 2 oxide reactor with hydrogen, dry hydrogen gas. We will get the copper plus water. So, a brown solid. Must remember the objective learning, observation brown solid produced. Black color powder turns to brown. Alright, sometimes they won't give the actual symbol. They will represent the symbol with not actual symbol. So, remember group 1 element is Lina. Okay, remember Lina, it will form positive 1 ion, so the reaction is here. Alright, so if let's say chlorine gas react with halogens on its iron wool, so remember how to do the formula. So I'll do here Fe react with Cl2, what product we will get. So I'll do here, so must take Fe3 positive, so here Cl negative, we will get iron. Alright, so we will get Fe Cl3. Alright. Okay, so how to balance, check here 2, here 3, so how to balance, so I'll do here times 2, so 6, here times 3, 6, iron 2, iron 2, alright, so we will get FeCl3, balance, put 2 here, put 3 here, put 2 here, so this is brown powder or brown colors powder will form. Alright, any question, please comment in the comment box. I will send the module to all the students. And remember the neutralization reaction marble, the chemical symbol for marble is chemical calcium carbonate. Alright, so sodium react with oxygen will get sodium oxide. When we take this sodium oxide dissolve in the water, Na2O reacted dissolve in the water. So what product we will get? Okay, so we check what product we will get. Okay, always remember, student must remember, when A plus with B, we should get C plus D. If let's say A plus with B, we get C plus B, try to remove the B. Alright, so we check this one. Okay, we try to check this one. So here, I take out the ion, sodium ion, oxide ion. So here, hydrogen ion, hydroxide ion. During chemical reaction, join. So we get sodium hydroxide. This one join. Okay, water. So always check, this is B. So here, I got B. So what we have to do, remove this one. Alright, so we check. So the equation will be sodium hydroxide. Only one reactant. So how to balance the equation? So we should be able to balance by put 2 here. Alright, so please check. Okay, and remember chlorine reacted with water. What product we will get? So I'll do your chlorine reacted with water. This is very special. Must remember, so chloride, water, we break like this, and this group is silicate, so we potong, we put like this. So this is joined, so we will get hydrochloric acid. This one will join behind here. We will get hypochlorous acid, strong bleaching agent. When we place a blue litmus paper, it will turn to red and bleach. Alright, so remember, chlorine, bromine will bleach, iodine will not bleach. So answer is here. Alright, check all the equation given here. And remember, this here SP PM metal nitrate is very important, so please check on the question 10. Alright, so this one, so always remember, when we take a metal nitrate, we heat it up, we get one product, two product, and three product. So which is metal nitrate, when heated up, so we will get a metal oxide plus a brown color gas, which is nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. This gas is a brown gas. All right so please remember, metal nitrate, zinc nitrate, and also lead 2 nitrate. Try to do question, so confirmatory test, everything can come out in the exam. And remember, preparation of insoluble salt, displacement of halogen. All right so we go for next one. How to do half equation if let's say the selectively chosen to be discharged, the ion is hydroxide ion, to be discharged at anode during electrolysis. So we check anode. So anode is a positive terminal under electrolysis. Anode undergo oxidation. So if let's say I put anode here, positive terminal, for hydroxide ion, how to do? Please take 4 hydroxide ion. These 4 hydroxide ion will repel each other because of the like charges. So what happens? So they donate 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron. So they donate 1, 2, 3, 4. So I put here 4 hydroxide ion. So they donate, so I remove there. Now the particles become neutral, so this one they will collide and will move here, will join here. This one will collide, break and move here, join here. So we get 1, 2 water molecule H2O. They donated 4 electron, they loses 4 electron. Okay, and this one will bonded together from oxygen. All right, so please check the answer here, and the observation will be the colorless gas bubbles which relights glowing wooden splinter is given off. All right, so all this, the chlorine gas, if let's say chloride ion are selectively chosen to be discharged at anion, okay, these are the half equation. Must remember, greenish yellow color gas bubbles are given off. If bromine, brown solution. If copper, brown solid deposited. If copper 2 ion is selectively chosen, brown solid deposited. If factor 1, the intensity of blue color become paler. If factor 3, active, the intensity of blue color remain unchanged. All right, so hydrogen gas, please remember, if oxidizing agent, reducing agent, oxidizing agent, so how to do, please check my module. All right, so we move on to the next one. How to do the chemical formula? If let's say this can come out in objective question, ammonium carbonate, so I'll write ammonium ion, carbonate ion, CO32 negative, when year 2, so year 1, so this one we cross here, so open bracket, NH4, close the bracket, put 2CO3, alright, and sometime they will give the formula as the name. So remember, transition metal, the special characteristic they shows different oxidation number, must state the oxidation number. So here lead 2 oxide, and remember this lead 2 oxide when hot will be brown color, when cold it will turn to yellow color. All right, so iron 2 sulfate, please check, it's a green color. Copper 2 oxide, please check, this is brown, black color powder. All right, okay, how to do ionic equation, and from the chemical equation we try to check, this is displacement reaction. All right, so how to do the ionic equation, I'll do here. All right, so when you check here, when single atom, so here ion, metal plus non-metal ion, so this is metal plus non-metal ion, and this is atom, and always remember sulfate ion. All right, sulfate ion will act as a sulfate ion. Again, nitrate ion will not involve in the displacement reaction, they will act as observation ion. So that means which ion, cancel this one, cancel this one. Magnesium exists as atom, copper exists as copper 2 ion, and in this displacement reaction, magnesium is more electropositive, therefore it will displace the copper 2 ion from its salt solution. All right, so magnesium 2 positive plus copper, a brown color solid will deposit, a blue color solution will turns to colorless. All right, check for sodium chloride react with calcium carbonate. So here I already given. All right, so this one already given, sodium hydroxide. Okay, sodium sulfate react with lead 2 nitrate. When there is no hydrogen ion, no hydroxide ion, this is salt. And when no hydrogen ion, no hydroxide ion, this is salt. Remember, salt, soluble salt. Remember the 4-point KNN ion. So this is potassium ion, sodium ion, ammonium ion. Alright, ammonium ion and nitrate ion. All these ion is a soluble salt ion. When they present, they dissolve. So here, this is sodium ion, nitrate ion. Therefore, this is soluble. Alright. Okay, this is soluble. So that means this is insoluble. Take the insoluble arrow. How to do ionic equation? Lead to sulfate. It made up of first ion Pb2 positive and the second ion SO4 2 negative. All right. Okay, so we go for next one. Okay, please take a minute and write down all the formula of the ions given in this page number 6. All right. So please try to do King Neto Catch Mango. So potassium ion, sodium ion, calcium ion, magnesium ion, aluminium ion, zinc ion, okay, iron 2 ion, tin, Sn2 positive, Pb2 positive, hydrogen ion, copper 2 ion, okay, Ag positive will be silver ion, ammonium ion. From all these ion, only 2 ion is colored ion, which is copper 2 ion is a blue color ion, and iron 2 ion is a green color ion. The rest will be colorless ion. And we check the negative N ion. So the N ion, F negative, SO4 2 negative, nitrate ion, chloride ion, carbonate ion, alright, so bromide ion, iodide ion, oxide ion, hydroxide ion, okay, thiosulfate ion, all right. So we go for manganate ion, MnO4 negative, dichromate 6 ion, Cr2O7 2 negative. From all these N ion, only 2 ion will be colored ion, which is this manganate 7 ion, purple color ion, and the dichromate 6 ion, remember the O basa, so that will be orange color ion. Okay, the rest will be colorless ion. Alright, so we check this one. If let's say in the exam they ask atom single, single is atom. Alright, if let's say they ask sulfur atom, so that will be S. Okay, if molecule, molecule made up of non-metal plus non-metal, they exist as particles, molecules. Alright, so please remember 5 non-metal, carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, and hydrogen. If let's say in the exam they ask sulfur molecule, please remember SA. I'll give you another example, phosphorus. Phosphorus atom, the formula will be P. If let's say in the exam they ask phosphorus, phosphorus molecule, okay, so phosphorus molecule will be P4, all right. So please remember, all the non-metal exists in most of the non-metal exists in gas state. How to draw is here, the arrangement further apart from each other, and the movement must put randomly. Solid is arranged closely packed and in order, they only can vibrate. And if let's say a metal ion present and non-metal ion present, metal, 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 belakang non-metal, 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 no need to remember, always remember, only remember in front. So this is metal plus non-metal, always exists in the ion form. So ion, all the metal ionic bonding, most of the ionic bonding exists in the liquid form, so closely pack all these. All right, please check this question, diffusion. So the diffusion, how to explain the diffusion based on the kinetic theory of matter. So the fried chicken gas smell are made up of tiny and discrete particles. The fried chicken gas smell move randomly and occupy the empty space between the air molecule. They move from the eye region, higher concentration region, to the lower concentration region. Okay, now we move on to the all the uses from form 4 and form 5 that are going to come out in your exam. So I'll start with isotope. Isotope, the one very famous is phosphorus. Alright, so phosphorus is SPM 2020. What is the function of phosphorus? Is used to determine the rate of absorption of fertilizer by plant or to study the plant metabolism. So answer given here. Alright, so next one will be krypton. Krypton under noble gases. This krypton is very famous for SPM 2020. So remember, is used in LASIK treatment to repair the retina. Ammonia, the formula of ammonia. Ammonia, remember NH3. Okay, NH3 exists as molecule. This ammonia is used to prevent the coagulation of latex. It's also used in making fertilizer. All right, so glass, very important glass, must remember the photochromic glass. So I'll do here, photochromic glass is used to make sunglasses. All right, so this is under composite material. All right, so CHROMIC, photochromic glass. So it's made up of glass and another substance very sensitive to the UV light. If let's say the intensity of UV light is higher, it will darken during daytime and become brighter during nighttime. That will be silver chloride or silver bromide, must remember. All right, so here we check. So that will be silver chloride and silver bromide. And superconductor, please remember bullet train. The cable system in the bullet train is made up of superconductor. It conduct electricity with zero resistance, MRI machine. Alright, please remember. Alright, we go for next one, steel. Stainless steel is very important for this one. So if steel made up of iron plus carbon, so here stainless steel, iron plus carbon, remain plus add one more chromium, is used to make a surgical instrument. And remember bronze. Bronze is very important. So what I do, bronze is made up of copper. Okay, and here brass is made up of copper and zinc. So remember, so I'll do here. Okay, if let's say bronze. Okay, so bronze and brass. Okay, so bronze and brass is made up of copper. Copper and minor component, take the Zn, put here, take the Sn, put here. So change, switch here. Copper plus Sn, this one bring here. Alright, so that n and bronze, please remember Tugu Negara or national monument. All right, so how to draw for bronze? Remember how to draw. This is a bigger atom, this is smaller atom, and this is a little foreign atom, right? Little, this is a lot. So how to draw? Put the Sn atom, sternum atom, and draw a lot of copper atoms here. After we draw, we try to label. All right, how to label? This is copper, copper atoms, and this will be our tin atoms. All right, so please remember. All right. Okay, so we go for next one. Polymers. The polymers, I'm targeting this one, SPM 2020 PVC. Okay, this is PVC. Polymer means long chain. The monomer is bonded in repeating sequences form long chain. The monomer is small identical subunit. And the monomer for PVC will be chloroethene. So that will be here. Alright, try to draw the structural formula of the monomer. So try to draw in the module so that you can remember. C double bond C, here got one H, here got one H. Alright, so this side should leave it empty. So here one, so here one H, and here we have Cl. This is the structural formula of monomer. Please remember raincoat and umbrella. Study Teflon and Perspex. Alright, for glass. The most important glass that going to come out in this SPM, can come out in this SPM, will be the glass that used for kitchenware. All right, the glass that can withstand high temperature. Okay, that is known as borosilicate glass. All right, so we go for next one. From five users. Okay, the sunny. Cold pack. Cold pack, normally we will remember ammonium chloride. Please remember another one also, another substance. Ammonium nitrate, ammonium chloride, another one very important, potassium nitrate. Alright, so we go for additive detergent. The substance that added in detergent to increase the cleaning action of detergent. Okay, biological enzyme already come out. Okay, so try to remember builder. Builder, the function soften the hard water or mud water by absorbing. Okay, calcium ion. Calcium ion and magnesium ion. Hard water contains high concentration of calcium ion and magnesium ion. Example of builder is known as sodium. This one wrong, so please change. Okay, sodium tripolyphosphate. All right, or sodium phosphate. Okay, and whitening agent also stay focused on the sodium perborate and sodium hypochlorite. It bleach the color of the skin without bleaching the color of the fabric. Drying agent keep the detergent in dry, enable to detergent for quick and easily. All right, modern medicine. Check the question. Modern medicine is used to treat. They can give the characteristic of the patient. The patient always hear voice and sound that not exist, and that is called hallucination. And for this type of need, the type of need will be antipsychotic. All right. So check on the barbiturate, sleeping pill, slow down the chemical reaction in our body and causes calm down the patient and causes the patient fall into sleep. Must remember the function also. All right. Okay. And is used to treat patient with restless and difficulty in sleeping. Tuberculosis under antibiotic. Why the antibiotic must finish as prescribed by doctor later, I will show it in this module. Aspirin. Why children below 12 years old cannot take aspirin? Another 2% who cannot take aspirin will be gastric patient and pregnant woman. All right, so we go for modern traditional medicine. Okay, the medicine that used to remove stomach wind or prevent flu, keep our body warm, and that will be ginger. So remember the ginger. Try to remember aloe vera also, how to use. You already given. All right, so for the food additive, I'm predicting stabilizer can come out in your objective question. The function of stabilizer is prevent, help to mix the layer of water and oil. It prevent the separation of oil layer and water layer in the food, and it also make the food become emulsion. All right, so emulsion. So when emulsion is look more attractive and people will buy. All right, so that will be under soy and lecithin, or one more, remember soy lecithin. All right. Okay, ascorbic acid, vitamin C is used as antioxidant. Antioxidant, please remember the key point, rancid, preservative, all this. Remember, if let's say in the exam, they give a canned food. All right, so I get a sardine food. Okay, here expiry date, they put 2022 or 2021. Which of the following radioactive isotopes? Okay, used to preserve the food in the can. So answer cobalt 60. All right, what is the function of preservative? Please remember. All right, okay, we go for the chapter 2. All right, chapter 2, page number 9, please check the module. What is mean by melting point? Normally student will put a point. point at which solid is converted into liquid. That is wrong answer. Alright, should not put what point. A temperature. Must remember a temperature at which solid change to liquid at certain condition or certain pressure. Okay, what is mean by nuclear number? If let's say I got X, I got sodium. Sodium 1123. The number besar will be nuclear number. Nuclear number means what? Total number of protons plus neutrons that present in pair in the nucleus of an atom. So total number of protons, neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. Why the temperature remain unchanged in the melting process? Try to draw the graph. Sketch the graph. Okay, melting process. So here, this is the graph. This is solid, liquid, mixture of solid plus liquid. Okay, so why the temperature remain unchanged? Because the heat energy is being absorbed used by particle to overcome the forces of attraction so that the particle can turn from solid to the liquid. Okay, which of the following function of isotope? I repeated again. Why? The more you repeat, the more you remember. Remember phosphorus 32 and also study others also lah. Alright, so we go for next one. Why the temperature remain unchanged during freezing process? So freezing process, try to remember the graph. Temperature, year, time. Why remain unchanged? Because the heat energy release is all these answers given. Okay, and three subatomic particles. If let's say in the exam they give subatomic particles in the atom. Remember PEN, proton, electron, and neutron. The smallest subatomic particles will be what? Smallest subatomic particles will be E. All right. And the introduce, the person that introduced, we have total how many person daddy takes. Takes what? Racket, back where? Back Chicago. Alright, remember John Dalton, J.J. Thompson, Racket, Ernest Rutherford, Niels Bohr, and James Chadwick. The person who introduced protons will be Ernest Rutherford. Alright, the person who introduced the electron will be J.J. Thompson. The person who introduced James Chadwick will be neutron will be James Chadwick. Check this drawing. So when they put here P plus N and they give structure like this, alright. They give you electron orbiting the nucleus in the shell, and they put here the word neutrons. The only one person introduced neutron, just choose James Chadwick. All right, so we go for next one. Okay, state the molecular formula. Study from my module. Why the copper 2 oxide cannot be used to determine the empirical formula for magnesium oxide? Okay, check this question. Okay, calculation will give you equation 2 marks, and the calculation to determine will be 3 marks. Total will be 5 marks. Alright, so how to do this question? So first, always circle this one. The number given, okay, do the equation like this. Then this is molarity, this is volume. First convert the structure into number of mole, find the number of mole. After that, try to find the ratio. Circle from the equation the sulfuric acid 1 mole, carbon dioxide 1 mole, then try to find the ratio like this. And after that, try to convert into the requirement, the question. They want the, what is the requirement of the question? What is the volume of carbon dioxide? So try to find the answer will be like this. All right, so check this one also. All right, so this one. Okay, we go for the properties of group 1 metal. The group 1 metal, please remember Lina. When going down the group 1, reactivity reactivity increases. Which one more reactive? Potassium. And this group 1 element is known as what? Alkali. Okay, metal. Alright, they are soft metal, can be cut by using knife. Okay, they have a shiny gray color solid. Okay, they must keep in the paraffin oil. I must remember all these. Okay, the special characteristic of transition metal, don't put as high melting point all. The special characteristic it has four. Number one, we'll start with, it shows more than one oxidation number, different oxidation number. They form colored ion or colored compound. They form complex ion. They act as catalyst. So we have all these, must remember. So answer is given. And remember the catalyst used in the process. Okay, the first one, Haber process. What is the name of the catalyst used in Haber process? Check. So the name of the catalyst used in Haber process is iron. Contact process, vanadium 5 oxide. Oxford process, platinum. Hydrogenation is nickel. Alright, so why argon is chemically inert? If let's say 2 marks is given, so we should write 2 points. Okay, and state the position of predict table. If let's say 5 marks is given, Okay, sorry, if let's say 3 marks is given, so how to answer? First, write down the electron arrangement of the element X and give the reason element X 6 valence electron in the outermost shell. Therefore, it has from group 16, element shell X must have put like this. It has 3 shell occupied or filled with electron. Therefore, it's from period 3. Alright, so we go for next one. Okay, this is very important topic, any subtopic that must remember why this one is reactive. If let's say 2 structure is given, how to answer this question? Okay, we check. Okay, so if let's say X, the atomic size of X is smaller and the atomic size of Y is bigger and the nucleus and the valence electron, the distance is getting further apart. Therefore, the nucleus forces of attraction here is stronger, here is weaker. So, which one can easily loses its valence electron and achieve stable octet electron arrangement? That will be Y. And Y will be more reactive than X. Why? Because the atomic size of Y is bigger than X. The nucleus forces of attraction of Y or the nuclear attraction forces of nucleus of Y towards its valence electron is weaker than X. Thus, Y easily loses its valence electron and achieves stable octet electron arrangement. And we when going down the group 17 halogen, the reactivity will be decreases. That means which one is more reactive? So P is more reactive. So answer P is more reactive. Why? Because the atomic size of P is smaller than Q. So answer all is given in this module. Okay, when going across the period, atomic size getting smaller. Why getting smaller? Because the proton number increases one by one. One by one, one by one, one by one. When the protons are, the number of protons increases, the positive charges in the nucleus also increases. This causes the attraction, nucleus attraction forces towards the electron shells become stronger. Thus, the electron shell is pulled closer to the nucleus, causing the atomic size or radius decreases. Alright, contribution. Remember Dmitri Mendeleev. Dmitri Mendeleev, okay, put here increasing AM, here increasing PN. So remember all these 5%, 4%, A, D, J, L, M, M. Antoine, he classified the element into 4 groups. Alright, the person who introduced triad law is John Dobiner. The person who introduced the octave law is John Newland. The person that plotted graph is Lottermeier. The person that arranged element according to ascending order of atomic maps will be Dmitri Mendeleev. Alright, the person, the father of modern periodic table is Henri Moseley. He arranged element according to ascending order of proton number. Alright, so answer is given here. Alright, check. Okay, we go for chemical bonding. Okay, the properties of chemical bonding, 3 properties. Chemical covalent bonding, 3 properties already given. Why sodium chloride solid can conduct electricity in aqueous or molten? Why cannot conduct in solid state already given? Okay, check this question. So, how to do this one? Sodium ion, sodium and oxygen atom combined together to form a chemical bonding. And always remember, do the electron arrangement 2.8.1, 2.6. And when the valence electron 1, 2, 3, all these is metal. Metal will form cation. What is cation? Positive ion. Okay, so positive ion, how they form? They donate the valence electron. Therefore, sodium will donate the 1 electron and form sodium ion 2.8, achieve stable octet electron arrangement. And this oxide ion, oxide atom, they will gain the electron. How many electron gain? So they need 2 more electron to achieve stable octet. Therefore, take the 2, put here 2 negative. The electron arrangement of oxide ion is 2.8. Try to get the formula. This one bring down. Give it to D. So this is the formula. Here we have how many ion? Sodium ion we have 2. So 2.8, 2.8. We have oxide ion 1, 2.8. Alright, so how to answer the formation of ionic bonding? Sodium atom with electron arrangement is 2.8.1. Sodium atom will donate 1 valence electron to achieve stable octet electron arrangement. A positive ion of Na positive is formed. Oxygen atom has electron configuration of 2.6. It will receive 2 electrons from 2 sodium atoms to achieve stable octet electron arrangement. A negative ion of O2 negative is formed. these sodium ion and oxide ion are attracted together by stronger electrostatic forces of attraction. All right, so we check next one. The formation of CCl4, sodium chloride carbon and chloride react together. They form a covalent compound. This is non-metal. All right, this is non-metal. When non-metal plus non-metal, so type of bonding, please remember, is a covalent bonding. Covalent bonding exists as molecule. They do what? They share valence electron. All right, so we check how to do the formula, how to get the formula. Carbon 2.4, chloride 2.8.7. So how to get the formula for covalent compound? Ask question. How to ask question? How many electron needed to achieve octet? The carbon need how many electron? 4. Chloride need how many electron? 1. Then you do crossing. Bring the 4 year, 1 year. So the formula will be CCl4. All right. How to draw for this one? So how to draw? So I'll do here. Okay. Check this one. So put here. Put inside the shell. Alright, outside we need to put 7 minus 1 outside the shell is 6, so only for chloride. So how to do? Check the formula, CCl4. So carbon at the middle, carbon first shell, second shell. Alright, so chloride, we have 1 chloride, 2 chloride, 3 chloride, 4 chloride. Okay, how to do the electron arrangement? So the valence shell go inside, so first shell, second shell, the valence shell put inside, the first shell, second shell, the valence shell put inside, first shell, second shell, all right, second shell, first shell, second shell, the valence shell go inside. All right, fill up the first shell and second shell. Okay, I fill up the first shell, 2 electron. Okay, 2 electron. Alright, so then carbon leave it, the valence shell do it lastly. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this one erase. Okay, do again. Okay, 1, 2. All right, so here we also do 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, check here, put inside 1 chloride, put inside shell. Okay, chloride, the inside put 1 chloride shell, inside put 1 chloride atom, put inside 1 chloride inside. Okay, outside put 7 1 sorry 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 all right 1 2 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, if give 1, should take 1. So that means chloride contribute 1 electron for sharing. That means carbon should give 1 also. So 1, 1, 1. So this is the one we try to draw for the electron arrangement for CCl4. Very easy, right? Okay, so we try to draw for sodium oxide. Sodium oxide, please check how to draw. So the answer is given. And also remember for carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, we have 2 double covalent bond. How to draw? Answer is here. Alright, so we go for next one. Okay, please check this one also. Alright, so we go for this one. State the meaning of electrolyte. The electrolyte is a substance that can conduct electricity in the molten or aqueous state, okay, and undergo chemical changes. Ethanol, C2H5OH, okay, is a covalent compound, non-electrolytes. Aqueous sodium chloride is ionic compound, electrolyte. When we have glacial or non-electrolyte, glucose is covalent compound, non-electrolyte. Molten aluminium oxide is ionic compound, electrolyte. Acid will show its properties in the presence of water. Organic solvent still exists as molecule. There is no freely moving hydrogen ion, therefore non-electrolyte. And please check this one, molten metal. For example, molten aluminium, molten copper. They can conduct electricity but does not undergo any chemical changes, therefore non-electrolyte. All right so we go for next one. Okay, drawing. Juan Roni brought a dozen of iron spoon and from the supermarket, it's found the iron spoon get rusted. She planned to electroplate the iron spoon. So how to do electroplating process? So want to do electroplating process, please remember this one. So drawing very important. So how to draw? I'll draw here. So I put here all divided into 3 knee. Okay, so anode, electroplating anode is a positive terminal, cathode is negative terminal. Alright, so the electrolyte I need is what? Alright, so remember these two ions, sulfate ion and nitrate ion. So here, electroplated iron spoon or iron key must place at the cathode. Alright, so cathode and the any metal, unreactive metal like silver, copper, all should be placed at cathode. This is silver, and the ion electrolyte must have the silver ion. So silver ion Ag positive, so choose the nitrate ion, so silver nitrate solution. All right, so we check the factor involved here. The factor is factor 3. All right, so how to draw? So I'll draw here. So we check the drawing. Always remember this electroplating have safety precaution. What are the safety precaution that student must remember? Number one, must use low current. So therefore we must place rheostat. All right, okay, and the spoon should be placed at negative terminal. Positive terminal is silver electrode, and we must spin the spoon slowly throughout the experiment. Must clean the spoon. Okay, spoon using sandpaper to obtain uniform layer of silver gray, shiny gray solid. All right, we go for next one. Okay, please check all these questions. So this is under electrolysis. Okay, so we try to do this one. All right, so if concentration factor, this is factor 2, when they use carbon electrode, factor 1 or factor 2, if concentration factor, always remember A naught, if chloride ion and hydroxide ion. So arrange the element according to ECS. So the cathode, okay, if let's say here they use concentrated sodium chloride solution, so cathode will be always choose the bawah. If let's say factor 2 anode, if chloride ion halide ion, choose atas. All right, so this is carbon electrode. Here they never give the molarity, that means this is factor 1 position of ion in the electrochemical series of ion. That means here anode always pilih bawah. All right, cathode always bawah. Alright, cathode always bawah. So the answer already given. Alright, so what happened to the intensity of blue color become paler? Why? Because the concentration of copper 2 ions decreases. Alright, in copper 2 sulfate solution. Alright, if factor 3, they must use active electrode. Active electrode, remember copper and silver. Okay, this is factor 3. Alright, factor 3. And how to answer? Answer is here. Why the intensity of blue color remain unchanged? Because the rate of ionization of copper atoms to copper 2 ion, okay, at anode, and the rate of copper 2 ions discharge to copper atoms at cathode are same. Therefore, the intensity of blue color remains unchanged, already given all here. Okay, if combine the volatic and electrolytic cell, how to identify which one electrolytic, which one volatic cell? Remember, volatic cell, they must have two different metals used as electrode. So check the cell here, zinc, this is copper with F2. Here they use same, so this is electrolytic, this is volatic. Check, okay, anode is what the metal that placed above. Always what terminal? Negative terminal. Undergo what reaction? Oxidation means what? Donate electron. So already this is donate electron going up, this one going down. So how to tick like this. All right, so all the answer already given, go through before your exam. Okay, now this is very important. Okay, came out in MRSM all. So remember, which of the following is rechargeable and non-rechargeable battery? Rechargeable battery will be first one, nickel cadmium battery, second one, lead accumulator battery, lithium ion battery, and lithium polymer battery. And non-rechargeable mercury, the one found in the watch battery, okay, and the dry cell, okay, alkaline battery, all this. Okay, and displacement reaction is a reaction where less electropositive metal will be displaced from its salt solution by a more electropositive metal. All right, so how to answer this question? You see here got changes. Okay, here got changes, right? So here test tube A got changes. That means when changes, always remember the P is atas. queue is bawah. Alright, so we check another one. Okay, next one got changes or not. Gray solid deposited. That means the P is atas, R is bawah. Okay, and here no changes. When no changes, S is atas, P is bawah. Alright, scan. Okay, and we check here no changes. The reaction does not occur. That means your R, Q is atas. Alright, so I'll do your Q is atas. And R will be at bottom. Now you summarize and do one arrange the element according to in the ECS. Atas will be okay S. Okay, next will be your P. Alright, P, and next will be Q. Q, and next will be R. Okay, and when going up like this, metal getting more electro positive. Alright, so how to arrange the element according to ascending order of their reactivity. So answer is here. How to explain this is test tube A, test tube B, test tube C, test tube D. The reaction between metal P and Q nitrate solution occur. Why? Metal P is more electropositive. Study. Predict what will happen if metal S is placed in Q nitrate. Metal S above and R nitrate, so S react with R nitrate. All right, so I'll check. Okay, R nitrate and O3, this is less electropositive, less, this is more. That means the reaction will occur. Why? Because S is more electropositive than R. All right, so we go for next one. Okay, meaning of strong acid, what? Check. Glacial ethanoic acid, no water. No water means no hydrogen ion. Okay, it won't ionize. Water absent in glacial ethanoic acid, therefore does not ionize. No hydrogen ion to show the predict the presence of acidic properties of acid. How to do this one? How to solve this problem? If let's say I have a glacial CH3COOH, how to make here they give you the pH value is 7.0. How to reduce the pH value at water? Okay, so answer is here. If let's say they give you the beaker, inside the beaker they pour hydrochloric acid and the pH meter is deep, so 1.0, this is pH meter 1.0, and they give another experiment here, they put CH3COOH weak acid and the pH value okay is 5.0. What is the differences between these two experiments? Cell, this is cell 1, this is cell 2. So the answer already given here. When the concentration of hydrogen ion is higher, the pH value is lower. So please remember all these for essay question. Okay, we go for next one. Titration is very important. So when burette fill up with sulfuric acid, alright, burette fill up with sulfuric acid and reacted with potassium hydroxide, the chemical equation please go through. This process is neutralization, and observation here, the solution will turn to pink color. At the end point, the solution will turn to colorless. Alright, colorless. Okay, and calculate the molarity. How to calculate the molarity? Use the formula and calculate. What happen if the experiment repeated by using hydrochloric acid to replace sulfuric acid? I don't know, sir. So we check here. So I take a beaker. Alright, so here I put hydroxide ion 2. Okay, here also another beaker. So I put hydroxide ion 2 ion. Alright, so I take a burette. I add a sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid is diprotic acid, and here they replace with hydrochloric acid HCl. This is known as monoprotic acid. So diprotic acid ionizes completely and produce 2 mole of hydrogen ion. So 1 sulfuric acid enough. They give you 2 hydrogen ion to neutralize. Here we need 2 hydrochloric acid molecule acid. So hydrogen ion. That means the volume getting 2 times. So here what is the prediction will be? Why? Because 2 times 2550. Why? Because sulfuric acid, diprotic, hydrochloric acid, monoprotic. In the same concentration, the volume of hydrochloric acid needed to neutralize the potassium hydroxide double or twice the volume of sulfuric acid. Please check the application also. Alright, we go for salt. Okay, salt is given. Okay, if nitrate salt, how to describe a confirmatory test? I'll do your... Okay, nitrate salt, I'll do here. So if let's say here they put nitrate ion. So how to test the confirmatory test to show the presence of nitrate? So we add dilute sulfuric acid followed by concentrated iron 2 sulfate solution, and we tilted the test tube or centered the test tube. We add 3 drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay, without shaking the test tube. What is our observation? A brown color ring will form. A brown ring will form at the middle of the solution. All these 3 cm power 3. Alright, so must remember the answer is given here. Alright, check. Okay, and we go for this one. Describe the confirmatory test to show the presence of zinc ion. If let's say I have a test tube solution with X positive, they add few drops of sodium hydroxide and shake the test tube. If let's say student get white color precipitate, this is white color precipitate, remember 5 ion, CaMpZ, alright, calcium ion, aluminium ion, magnesium ion, lead 2 ion, zinc ion, and if let's say they take the white color precipitate, they add excess, alright, they add excess of sodium hydroxide or excess of ammonia solution and shaken well. If white color precipitate soluble in excess, so we have put soluble in excess of sodium hydroxide and ammonia solution. Remember only one ion, which is zinc 2 positive ion. So how to answer? Answer is given here. All right, check. Okay, and which of the composite material, remember, so and remember which substance with same high temperature, that will be borosilicate glass. All right, we go for polymer and our monomer and how to get the polymer. All right, look at this question. Draw the monomer of the following polymer given. So how to draw? So here is repeated. So cut the structure here. After cut the structure, we try to write here. Okay, CH. Okay, here I have H, here I have CH3, and when got double single bond, okay, make it double, so I'll put double. So now rearrange the structure, 1, 2, we have total 3 carbon, 1, 2, 3, the double bond start after carbon number 1, so each carbon must have 4 bonding, so this is the monomer. The name of the monomer is prop. 1-E-N-E, alright, so must remember. Okay, if let's say in the exam they give you natural, they ask the monomer of natural rubber. Okay, monomer of natural rubber is known as isoprene. We must remember another monomer name, methyl boot 1,3-diene. Alright, 2-methyl boot 1,3-diene. So how to do this one? Draw the structural formula. So 3-4-C, 1-2-3-4. We got 2 double bond diene, so 1 carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. Carbon number 3, we have double bond after carbon number 3. Erase all these numbers. Alright, so we check methyl present at carbon number 3. So here CH3, must draw the structural formula. Each carbon must have 4 bonding, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is the structural formula of the monomer of natural rubber. If this monomer undergo polymerization, how to do equation? So what I do, I cut the long chain. After I cut the long chain, what I do, I rewrite here, C double bond here. Okay, so I make a rearrange the structure, make sure the site is empty, CH3 H H H, then I open bracket, close bracket, so here put N. Okay, we don't know how many numbers of molecules, so we represent with N. All right, so we try to check. When you see your double bond, make it single. When you see your single bond, okay, you make it double. All right, so when you see your double bond, you make it single. That's all. So I open bracket, I close the bracket, I put 1, 2, 3, 4, I put all the hydrogen like this. Okay, I draw one omba like this and put N. Whenever you see double bond, make it single. So here double bond, here single. All right, so this is the equation for the polymerization of natural rubber. All right, so we go for next one. Okay, state the optimum temperature that needed for this one. So remember, okay, and contact process, above for contact process, the first stage will be, this is stage one. Sulfur, dry sulfur react with dry eye oxygen to produce Ni. Second stage will be this one. Second stage, third stage will be what? Okay, what is the name of this product? This product is oleum. Okay, what is the name of this product? This product will be oleum. Okay, and here at this stage, what we add? We add concentrated sulfuric acid. Alright, concentrated sulfuric acid. This process, stage 4, is known as dilution state. Okay, we add water. Okay, why copper? Pure copper, bronze is harder than pure copper. So why? So answer is here. Please check, then repeat it. Alright, so check all these. Okay, and we go for Form 5 chapter, rate of reaction. What is mean by change rate of reaction? If they put in this reaction, write down the equation, check got volume of gas. If volume of gas, volume of carbon dioxide, write down the equation, rate of reaction. Okay, we put what? Change. Change in the total volume of carbon dioxide per unit time taken. Then only you convert into the definition. Okay, example of slow reaction, remember, fast reaction, remember. Okay, the condition required for the collision theory, we have two condition, correct orientation, they must have equal or more activation energy. The factor must remember, five factor, size of reactant, concentration of solution, temperature and presence and amount of catalyst, pressure. Not factor, please remember, mass and volume. All right so we go for next one. How to explain? So this year we have a concentration, maybe it can come out. Hydrochloric acid is monoprotic, sulfuric acid is a diprotic. Please remember how to answer is here given. Okay, and what is the characteristic of catalyst? Catalyst is a chemical substance added in small quantity to alter the rate of reaction without itself involved in the reaction. So how to answer? So catalyst is used in small quantity, can reuse again, not affect the product or quantity of product or reactant. Okay, does not undergo physical changes but may undergo physical changes, can alter or increase the rate of reaction, and the reaction of catalyst is specific. All right please remember how to draw energy. This is known as energy profile diagram. Energy profile diagram, how to get the energy? EA is stand for activation energy, the minimal energy required by reacting particles to react. All right okay, we go for hydrocarbon. Okay, what is meant by hydrocarbon? It contains hydrogen and carbon only. Hydrocarbon is a compound that contains carbon and hydrogen only, saturated. Please remember, if saturated, alkene. If unsaturated is alkene. Okay, the general formula must remember. So how to remember? Must write with N. Okay, all these must remember. Okay, all right so isomerism. Okay, try to check my YouTube video, I got two isomerism, try to learn from the video. All right so if want to differentiate the butane C4, H will be 8 plus 2 10. Butene C4, H will be 8. Which one can undergo oxidation? Butene. So how to answer is here. Calculation to determine the sootiness of the alkane and alkene. Which one will produce? This is hexene C6H12. This is hexane C6H is 14. Which one will produce more soot? So answer is here. Okay, conversion of carbon compound. Please practice. I already give you 7. Practice combustion, hydrogenation, halogenation, okay, hydration, oxidation of alcohol, esterification, all these practice. Okay, fermentation also, please remember. Okay, and from this conversion of carbon compound, 3 conversion F condition. Must remember. Okay, we have one more, dehydration. For dehydration, please remember, if you want to convert alcohol into alkene, we need a porcelain chip. Al2O3. Okay, and one more, hydration, we need to get the concentrated phosphoric acid. Please remember, satu pusingan lengkap 360 degrees Celsius, 60 atm pressure. Nickel for hydrogenation condition under 80 degrees Celsius. Esterification, concentrated sulfuric acid heated under reflux. Drawing, please remember, dehydration. Okay, dehydration for drawing. And in this drawing, we will take a glass wool, react with butanol, porcelain chip, Al2O3, and we must use displacement method. And please remember the rubber stopper should be above than the boiling tube. Alright, so how to do butene gas? Okay, then here must have a retort stand, butene C4H8. Always remember alkene and 2 until and 3 and 4. All these exist as colorless gas. Alright, to test, you just add bromine. Okay, bromine solution. So when you add bromine solution, the brown bromine solution will turn to colorless. All right, please remember. Okay, to prevent the coagulation of latex, so we will use ammonia solution or ammonium hydroxide solution. Okay, please remember, by using suitable diagram, determine the coagulation, describe the coagulation of latex. Rubber particles are covered by protein membrane or enveloped by protein membrane. So here we have rubber polymer labeled. Okay, this is rubber polymer. Alright, so this is protein membrane. The surface of protein membrane is negatively charged. Alright, so try to check the answers here. Alright, so we go for, if rubber latex is not treated, it will coagulate itself. Why? Method to prevent is here. Why natural rubber less elastic than vulcanized rubber? Answer is here. Alright, okay, what is the process involved during oxidation? We have how many points? You must remember all this process. Okay, so remember oxidation. So here I put oxidation, here I put reduction. Remember 4 points, gain oxygen, loses oxygen. Okay, I oxidation, remember this one. I don't like E, so loses hydrogen, gain hydrogen, loses electron, gain electron, increase in oxidation number, decrease in oxidation number. Answer is given. The substance or reactant that undergo oxidation act as reducing agent, all these must remember. Alright, example of redox reaction, non-redox reaction is here. Okay, displacement of metal, displacement of halogen, remember. Alright, okay, all these must remember, this is reactivity series of metal. Okay, those students from different school, please try to message me. I will give the module to you guys. Alright, so this one must remember. Okay, we go for example of oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Example of oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Must remember 6 oxidizing agents. So I'll do here. Okay, oxidizing agent undergo reduction. So give me all 5 or 6 oxidizing agent: acidify, potassium magnate 7, acidify, potassium dichromate 6. All right, so chlorine solution, bromine solution, iodine solution, any solution that contains iron 3 ion. Okay, let me drink water first. Alright, okay, sorry guys. Okay, this let oxidizing agent undergo reduction. Okay, reduction means gain electron. Reducing agent, please remember. Okay, electron transfer at distance, always start from oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent, this agent undergo reduction. In electron transfer at distance, anode will be negative terminal, cathode will be positive terminal, cathode undergo reduction. This is positive, this is negative. Take the flow of electron from negative to positive. Okay, and try to do equation Fe3 positive gain 1 electron form Fe2 positive. Answer is given. Alright, okay, and potassium hydroxide, colorless solution. Potassium iodide is colorless solution. We have K positive and I negative. This one 2.8.8 already achieved stable, so will not involve. This is the one we will involve. So 2 iodide ion. Arrow, we get iodine plus 2 electron. Okay, colorless solution turns yellow or reddish brown. Alright, so how to test this one? Remember 1, 1, 1. Okay, dash trichloroethane solution. So answer is here. It will give purple color solution. Alright, so we go for next one. Okay, thermochemistry, almost going to finish, stay focused. Thermochemistry, please study everything. Alright, so we go for cold pack again. Okay, so please remember ammonium nitrate, ammonium chloride, or you can take ammonium. Okay, ammonium chloride. All these will dissolve in water and will absorb what any eat. Okay, odd fact, remember when we have hydrochloric acid, weak acid, ethanoic acid, strong acid, what is the differences between the heat of neutralization? Answer is given. Alright, okay, what is mean by soap? Soap is a sodium or potassium salt of fatty acid. Please remember this one. R. Okay, please remember this one. Okay, it's C. CH3 bracket CH2 close the bracket 14 COO negative and A positive. And this is positive, so the name of this soap, sodium palmitate. Sodium palmitate, must remember. Alright, so soap making process is saponification. If in the exam they ask what is a detergent making process, so detergent making process is sulfonation. Alright, so all this remember. Why, what is the function of adding sodium chloride? To reduce the solubility of soap in the water so that the maximum amount of soap can be precipitated. Why soap ineffective in hard water? Hard water contains what? Okay, higher concentration of calcium and magnesium ion, and ion of soap will combine with this ion and form okay insoluble salt known as scum. So foam cannot form, so an ion of soap will fail to clean. How to make soap detergent? Please remember my question. How to make soap more effective in hot water? That means we have to add additive detergent. What is the additive at detergent? Can remove the calcium and magnesium ion by adding builder, which is sodium tripolyphosphate. Alright, okay, the cleaning action of soap, okay, is less effective than detergent in hot water. Why? So answer is here. Okay, example of additive detergent is given here. Please study. Alright, okay, and we move on to the analgesic. So analgesic relief pain, paracetamol, the side effect remember, and please remember antipsychotic hallucination. Alright, okay, and stabilizer will be N-lecithin, or one more we use soy lecithin. All right, okay, cool. All right, that's all from me. Thank you very much. I will come up in another slot, 10 Ramalan experiment for paper 2 section C. Okay, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much, guys. Take care. Bye bye.